you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment, would you capture it? Let it slip.
Yo.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choked, he's so mad.
Patrick has raised over $1,000 for charity here tonight in the black corner there. Patrick, the chosen one, Joe. And now, time to welcome, at 44 years of age, 176 centimetres, 79 kilos, he's raised $1,265 for charity here tonight in support of Akon, of course, Pride in Sport. From New Zealand, is a Kiwi here tonight, a creative director at SBM, and the reason he's doing corporate fighter, taking myself out of my comfort zone, doing something new and challenging, and committing to something for 10 weeks was an appealing mix of fun as well as being daunting. Well, here it is. Please welcome the Timinator, Tim Hill!
So we're getting set for bout number four for Corporate Fighter 72. Patrick Cho in the black, Tim Hill in the white. This should be a terrific bout between these two. 15 years of age between the two. That's the biggest gap that I can see. 4 centimetres only in height and 9 kilos in weight. So it'll be interesting to see how the tail of the tape goes in this one and what impact it has. Cho seems to be very quick out of the corner. Nice little start from Hill. Big strikes from the young Kiwi. The young South Korean is very, very quick on his feet. Beautiful footwork already from Cho. Just challenging the Kiwi a couple of times here in the opening exchanges of this one. That was a nice little shot there from the Timinator though. Man, they call the chosen one. Just got a big right there from Tim Hill. And he responds beautifully with a nice left and right. Both of these fighters going for the top shelf at the moment. You hear the support for both of these fighters. A big shot there again from Hill. Cho seems to be a little rattled, but look at that steely focus that he's got. Hops and skips away from his opponent. Constantly moving, constantly challenging Hill. Hill seems to be reading it pretty well though. Big strikes again from the chosen one as the Timinator strikes back. very big, powerful contacts. Hill just works the midsection, tries to jam his opponent into that corner. On the ropes. Cho now very fast and flashy. That's a nice little combination there from the man in black. Cho just constantly just moving about. He's got very impressive footwork, and Hill is reading the situation well. The young Kiwi just going for the top shelf there with a couple of shots. Nice work from Cho to return serve. Final moments of this opening round of this fourth bout. There's the bell in the background. Pretty impressive start between the Chosen One and the Timinator. Big thank you to our sponsors, Akon Pride in Sport, which are a national sporting inclusion program specifically designed to assist sporting organisations of all levels with the inclusion of employees, athletes, coaches, volunteers and spectators with diverse sexualities and genders, and of course Will to Live provides the support and basic human needs to the marginalised and disenfranchised members of society. We're proudly fighting for Akon Pride in Sport and of course Will to Live. For Corporate Fighters 72, Charity Fight Night on pay-per-view. Wonderful to have your company wherever and however you're watching us. Maybe it's here in Australia, maybe overseas, maybe it's the middle of the day, maybe you're in the Northern Hemisphere. So Cho and Hill now back into it, second round action. Cho just navigates a couple of those lefts. Hill returns serve. Big shots again there. Nice work from the young Kiwi in white. It's a beautiful little combination from Cho. Works the midsection magnificently. Hill just jams his opponent into that corner. Oh, that's a flying uppercut there from Cho. Seemed to leap off the canvas when he fired the shot. Big shots again from the young Kiwi to return serve. Hill just rattles Cho on that combination. Cho again, the young South Korean, just ducking and weaving his way through the punches as Hill delivers some nice glove work. Couple of lefts and rights. Cho bounces back. Big strike with the left there from Cho. A swinging right from the young South Korean. And the young Kiwi, what's he got in his bag to fight back? Couple of lefts and rights. Impressive left there. As they regroup, resettle and reset. Hill just mauls over the top of his opponent. And the young man in black responds beautifully to get himself out of trouble pretty quickly. Cho, a left, a low left, and a high right. He is very flashy. Impressive footwork. You can see that he's got a little bit of in-ring experience leading into this 10 weeks. Either that or he's learned exceptionally quick. Final moments of this second round. That little set two from Hill just rattled Cho. What have they got in the final moments? Both fighters go for the top shelf. Big strike there from Hill to finish it. And some wonderful respect from Cho. Up next, it'll be Paddy Walsh, the young man from Ireland, taking on the Englishman, Ben Fraschini, from Stoke-on-Trent. 7 years separates the two. In terms of height, there's a fair bit of difference there. It's about 16 centimetres there. And in terms of weight, there's about 15 kilos. So a bit of gaps there in the tail of the tape. It'll be interesting to see what impact that has on the fight, whether it favours or hinders the fighters. The daddy taking on Big Bad Ben. That'll be up next, bout number five, and then we'll break for our first round of auctions. Just a heads up, you of those at home watching tonight, unfortunately you can't bid on the items. You can, of course, if you come to a Corporate Fighter event. But bidding on those items is unavailable to our viewers, unfortunately. But maybe use that as an excuse to come to another event as Cho starts with a big left and right. And then what's the Kiwi got in his bag here? Cho's hopping and skipping towards his opponent. Look at Hill come back. Cho's fighting with some lefts and rights. Works the midsection beautifully. Now tries to go for the top shelf. Resets. Goes again. Cho now fires back. Big shots from the young South Korean. Nice shots from Hill. The Kiwi's got him in the corner. And smacks his opponent with a beautiful left. And Cho returns serve. These two fighters, the intensity has really lifted another notch in this final round. Crowd on their feet here at Royal Randwick. Really getting into this one. Big shots here from the Kiwi. Top shelf goes Hill. Cho, the young South Korean, now works the midsection. Beautiful left, responds with a right, bounces off the ropes. Serves a couple of more shots. Hill's got a few more in his bag. Cho launches with a left. Impressive right. Very impressive left. There's a couple of uppercuts. And it rattles the Kiwi. But he manages to stay upright. He is tough with a capital T. And he's now firing back. Fatigue really starting to kick in for these two fighters. They're putting on an enormous show. There's going to be such a big roar at the end of this one. Oh! Cracking shots from both fighters. Nice shot there from Cho. Hill, it just went through the gate, but that was fatigue. Final moments. What have they got? Hill return serve. Beautiful lefts and rights there from Cho. The young South Korean goes high, and Hill shows respect. A great reaction from the Royal Randwick crowd here tonight. What a fight it was between these two. Patrick Cho and Tim Hill. Maybe the fight of the night so far. Maybe the fight of the Corporate Fighter 72. We shall see. Up next, it'll be Paddy Walsh taking on Ben Fraschini. That should be a good bout. Jason, who wins this one between Cho and Hill?
Ladies and gentlemen, what a fight that was. Another round of applause for our fighters. And our winner tonight, in the black corner,